Welcome to Dynamic Living, the your favorite program in Hope Channel. This is the 11th year of this program, and this episode we will be concluding our whole month of celebration for the 11 years anniversary. This time we are reversing our rules. Our host now becomes our guest, Dr. Rajin. We thank you so much for having been with Dynamic Living for the last 11 years. I'm Pastor Gofan, the Hope Channel Chairman here in South Philippines. And I want to introduce to you the other guests that we have this afternoon. We have Pastor Nelson Paulo, the Communication Director, largely behind all the programs that you can see in Hope Channel. Ayn, she has been our Dynamic Living producer through the years, and she's still very actively involved today. And we have Andrew, the representation of our technical staff, the guys whom you can never see, but the ones who make real what you can see on our TV screen. So good afternoon, everyone.
May
hapon, Dr. Rajin.
Yes. Thank you very much for inviting me as your guest now.
Oh, I feel very awkward, Dr. Jin. Throughout the years, you had been asking the questions. Now you will be answering questions.
Yes, and maybe I would learn to love that.
Oh, you will still continue to do your role, though. This is just a break because we are making a conclusion for our month celebration. And we are very pleased to see you. At least people will know now that this is the face behind his presentation, the producer of the program itself.
Thank you, Dr. Gofan, for having me. Thank you for the staff. Thank
and
you.
Also, Pastor Nelson, it's so good to see your familiar face, one of the favorite faces in Hope Channel South Philippines.
It's a privilege to be here with Dynamic Living team, especially on this concluding part of the 11 years of praising God for the victory that we attained, because God has been behind this program. And he's using a person that has developed not only quality, but a certain aura that attracts the people to God, not only to herself.
Thank you very much. Let me begin my interview with you guys. Pastor Paulo, did we also have other programs aside from Dynamic Living? Dynamic Living is flagship of this channel. Did you also have, in the history of the program production in this channel, did you also have other programs aside from Dynamic Living?
Yeah, we can see that Hope Channel is producing lots of programs today. And our viewers can attest to the fact that they can see Pangutana Pastor, Let's Pray, Taknas Pagtuon, Panimbaya sa Kabuntagon, and In This Generation, Nature Speaks, something like that. We also have some other programs that are already in queue. We will just be waiting for the right time to go on air. And that is how God has blessed SPUC and started with a very good program, Dynamic Living, which inspired the rest of the members, because some of those programs that we developed were being produced by her team, Dr. Jin.
Dr. Jin, some people has the impression that when we talk about Hope Channel, they are going to view religious programs. But then Dynamic Living has broken that kind of impression, because we are not showing religious programs itself. We are showing vital informations on the different aspects of life, social aspect, economic aspect, and all the others. May I ask you the question, how did Pastor Paulo approach you, or how did this whole thing begin, Dynamic Living itself? Can you give us a brief history of that?
Yeah, 11 years ago, I think I was invited as a guest by in one of the old programs of Hope Channel, which was not Hope Channel then, and that was actually a health program by Pastor Perez and his wife. And so I was a stand-in guest at the time. I wasn't supposed to be the guest and host at the same time, but somewhere along the line, the host was absent because he was sick. And so the guest then was actually Pastor Paulo. Mm-hmm. And so I was invited to be a stand-in host for that particular episode. And then maybe he saw something in the way I handled the show and everything. So he went to my clinic and he approached me and told me that there is a demand for a health show. Would I be willing to host that show?
Wow, thank you very much. Ayan, can I ask you a question? Some people are thinking, you know, that a program is a program being worked out by a large staff members. There are people behind each presentation. One of the most important rule in the program production is that of the producer herself or himself. Can you tell us anything about that role, particularly your role in the production of Dynamic Living?
Okay, thank you, Elder. Being a producer for Dynamic Living has been a challenge, a big challenge. At first, I thought it was I could handle the job easily. But then along the way, when I started inviting guests, and then they started not taking me seriously because perhaps that time I was still younger, and then I looked younger, so they thought that I wasn't someone who would be serious in what I'm doing. So I had to come back, and then they always send me to one person to another, and then after that, eventually they refer me to someone who is not very appropriate for the particular episode that we are planning. So that time I thought na perhaps there's something in me that I need to change, because at that time, I really did not have the personality of a producer, whatever that personality is that time. So eventually, I talked to some of the seasoned staff, the other staff who are much older and more experienced, and then they just encouraged me, despite all the discouragements, no, and that the challenges, they just encouraged me to move on with the show and then with producing. And then eventually I got to learn how to invite guests properly, how to make them treat me seriously. And then after that, I became not just the producer who invites the guest, but also the script writer. Wow. And that's the most challenging part, because that time I wasn't married yet, so okay. I have my time for myself only. So that time I sleep at around 4 a.m. just to finish my script. And of course, Doc is a very encouraging and understanding host.
Wow.
Yes, so
Demanding.
I won't say demanding, just perfectionist maybe.
Okay.
So that's very challenging for me, the inviting and then the writing part.
Okay. Dr. Jean, while listening to the narrative of the history from other sources, I understand that you were actually just being approached by Pastor Paulo, proposing that you will be one of the hosts of a program for Hope Channel. Did you really conceive ahead of time that you will not just be as a doctor, a health lecturer? Whose idea is it that this program will be a talk show and full of dynamism? Because, you know, it has to stand to its name, Dynamic Living. Whose idea is that? Is that from you or from anybody else, that it will be a talk show and a dynamic talk show?
So let me go back to the time that Pastor Paulo approached me in my clinic.
Okay.
My first impulse, actually, he knows that I said no. I told him no, because I don't have the training, I don't have the background for TV hosting, and it will get in the way of my being a professional doctor who's so busy servicing Region 10 and the surrounding areas, because at the time I was so busy with my practice. And then he went back again, he could not say take a no, so I went to see Elder Diaz then. So I asked him and I told him my concerns, my fears that I may not be able to handle the show. And he prayed for me, and then he said, you should service the community. And with that word, you have to serve as a community. So when Pastor Paulo again approached me, this time he approached me, he sat beside me while I was in church because he could not accept a no. So I told him, let's talk again and see how the concept would be. And so we were starting to discuss already what the show would be all about and how it would be. And I gave him also, I told him, okay, just because you're so persistent, let's give it 1 quarter only, just 3 months. And then if it doesn't, you know, take full swing at the time, because somewhere along the line, I'm not really fit to be a host, I told him, let's put a stop to it. And so he agreed. He said, okay, three months would be fair enough. But eventually, as we went along, we started discussing the concept of the show. Now we created a team. And so it now involved the team of Andrew, Janster, everybody else were there. And so we started talking, what would be the concept of the show? So the concept of the show then was purely relevant to the totality of a person. So we started with health, with our aim reaching the A, B, and C classes. So that was the start of dynamic living. But eventually, through the years, we saw that there is also a need for other relevant issues. It becomes social, financial, everything, spiritual, physical, so everything. So we now ventured and diverted just purely from health to different areas of the life of a person. And then we also noticed that people from all walks of life are now watching the show. And so we, every year, we would sit down, the team would sit down, we would brainstorm on how to be able to come up with better shows that would entice people to watch when they open their television sets. They would be waiting for Dynamic Living to start.
Well, I want to now come to Andrew. Andrew actually is a representative of what we call the unsung heroes of any television presentation. They are people who do what they are supposed to do very humbly. They are content to being just in the background. They are content that their faces are never seen on the screen, only that brief time that their names appear at the end of each program as staff members who has been in charge of the production. Andrew, can you tell us the limitations of the technical equipments that we have at the beginning, about 11 years ago, or at the time when you joined the Hope Channel and have started producing Dynamic Living? Can you tell us the technical limitations and equipments that we have?
The first time I came to Hope Channel, Dynamic Living already exists.
Okay.
Og mauni siya ang nakapahimo na ko nga sumbanan. Dari ko nakabalo.
Okay.
Dayon, among equipment, ang equipment sa Hope Channel sa una, it's just small cameras, lahi-lahi og brand, lahi-lahi pod og tagiya. So, gastruggle mi sa color, kaya siyempre kung lahi ang color, o lahi ang brand, lahi pod siya color. Dayon, gastruggle mi sa, and Dynamic Living mangod is live. So, usahay ang among, gamay mabungod kay mong studio. So kalit lang during sa live mo na ay mawala og kalit nga signal, na ay kamera nga mapalong lang og kalit. So amo na siyang suong-suongon, dili man pwede undangon kay live man. So musuong ka nga dili ka makita sa camera. Then at that time sa pagsugod na mo, wala mi intercom. So magtinanaway ra mi sa kumong kauban nga cameraman pod kung kinsa nay sunod, ikaw na ba, kay wala man mi intercom sa pagsugod. Pero gipadalanginan sa Ginoo ang sa technical side, nakahimutang na natay equipment na dire gyud ako nakita ang pagtubo sa Hope Channel kauban ang Dynamic Living.
Oh, thank you very much. Pastor Paulo, being the person whom shall we say equivalent to movies, you're actually director in the Hope Channel. And that is not an easy job. In most cases, programs that are seen by people on the screen are produced by professionals. Can you tell us what the qualifications are of the staff that you have started using in the production, such as what we have in Dynamic Living?
Yeah, it's good that in the beginning, I did not have any concern with technical excellence when you start a program, because had I known about it, I would be the number one to be discouraged. to start a program, especially with this host, who is very meticulous in details in programming. In fact, if it is not in your script, did you ask her the monetary consideration when the program was started? When I approached her, I hope it is in your script that you should ask her that when we started to court her, okay, and yes, at least there should be a match of that, okay, where is the monetary backing? I hope it, if it is not there, please ask me later, or we'll continue with your question on the quality, or how are we going to compete with the existing programs that others are seeing in Kagan de Oro, especially that we are very ambitious that it should be seen not only in Cagayan, but also in some other places where we can use technology just like video streaming or some other means. So I did not know about that, but I only knew that these people that were already there in place had that skill, and not only skill that is that could be contained only within Cagayan de Oro, but a skill that you can really be proud of. Johnster, Rami, these are two individuals, Bibing Sanes, who was then a manager at the same time doing the technical work. They are quality people, professionals that can really produce programs competitive to what you can see outside.
Okay, that led me to go back to Ayn, because I'm thinking his role, you know, being the producer. What background did you ever have prior to being asked as a producer? Have you been through a mass comm class? Do you have the degree? Or, I mean, can you share the qualification or the motivation part of your being a producer? Can you share that with us?
Elder, my degree in college is communications.
Okay,
so it's
good.
Similar to mass comm. But my experience in this kind of industry was only limited to my college years.
Okay.
Because right after college,
requirements, huh?
Yes, sir. Right after college, I took up units to become a teacher. And so by profession, I am a teacher. I've never worked in an industry such as this. My only exposure was when I had my internship at SSD under Pastor Catolico. And after that, this was the next. So I never had any professional background. It's just that because when I was younger, I really wanted to become a broadcaster, but it was only until college. After that, it shifted to becoming a teacher. So when Pastor Paolo and Doc Jean and Pastor Catolico approached me, I was somewhat overwhelmed because it was already several years after college that they approached me. And then, of course, my background has been long forgotten.
Okay.
So when I started, I had to start from scratch. So that was really very difficult for me.
No, you know, while thinking about the answer of Ayn, I was thinking that dynamic living actually is a demonstration that there is someone else who has bigger things in mind before these things have come to our minds. We believe that our God, the divine providence, He is the supreme being who really has some things in mind and can only look down and say, I will do this and I'll use these people. In the religious parlance, we say God knows whom He has given the spiritual gifts. Imagine a physician becoming a host in a talk show. Imagine someone who has been who had limited background making a production, who has limited experience in the technical stuff, in the technical matters, and yet has become expert just through experience. And a person who is first of all a mathematician who has become a minister, now becoming a director in a Hope Channel television such as what we have. Now, that brings us to the idea, really, that anything that comes to our mind is already in the mind of one who is above us. And we praise God for that. May I ask Dr. Jean this year, as the years went by, You must have met some challenging experiences. There must have been situations when you said, I have done enough, that is it. Did you ever have that, and how did you overcome that, and has made you survive the 11 years?
Well, I think let me go back to what Pastor Paulo said a while ago, that when one of the considerations at the very start when we started Dynamic Living was finances.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
So at that time then, what we did was actually, at the very beginning, for the first year, I think, I was actually the script writer. I was the producer of my show. I didn't have any help at all because it started as health. So I would do my own research, invite my own set of guests. So naalala mo yung group, one-on-one lang yun eh. Uh-huh. So for the first year, I only had one guest for the entire hour. And I was the one who financed it personally for the shows to, you know, be able to finish for the entire show, because it's expensive to have a show without financial backing. Of course, the administration pays for the electricity and everything. But then remember that all the members of the team are volunteers. And so where would they get the money for calling the guests or for following up, for their allowances in coming to the studio, for their pamiliti and everything? So it was personally funded for 4 years. But on the third year, when we started expanding the concept of the show, what we did was to get people now, more members of the team. So that's when we have producers now, we have script writers, because I could not handle that anymore. And as to your next question, but before I forget, Pastor, the concept of dynamic living was actually premised on three things. Number one, our guests should be, alam nila ayun yan eh, na ang guests namin dapat camera friendly.
Okay.
So ibig sabihin, kailangan maganda tingnan sa camera, di ba ayun? Isa yun sa aming criteria. Pangalawa sa criteria namin sa guests namin, they should be credible in their areas of expertise. Mm-hmm. In other words, nobody can question whatever they say in the show. The third one actually is they can be able to explain. So there are three C's there eh. And so we were very choosy with our guests. At yung sinabi naman ni Ayn kanina na nahirapan din talaga sila, which is actually the same problem for all the producers of the show. We have Charm, we have Natalie, we had Obed, we had Jade, and everybody else involved here. Was actually, tama yung sinabi niya, Pastor, nahihirapan kaming kumuha ng guests initially. Kasi nga, people were asking, what is hope? Where is that? Di ba, Ayn? Parang, yes. they don't take us for real. Parang, if it's ABS-CBN maybe, if it's GMA Networks, naku, napakabilis lang mag-imbita. But here we are, new people in the business. And so, nobody was taking us very seriously. So, yun yung sinabi ni Ayn, Elder, na hirap kaming kumuha ng guests. But more than sa hirap is, actually, the experiences that we had na hindi kami susulputin ng aming guests. O kaya naman, padadalhan kami ng ibang guests na hindi fitted for the show. So parang, here am I, a host, what do I do? Should I cancel the show or not? But our motto then was, proceed. No matter what happens, bagyo man yan, umulan man, walang kuryente, wala yung aming isa, dalawang guests, we proceed with the show. So that basically sums up yung kung gaano kagaling yung team ng Dynamic Living. Now, we were able to push through. And basically, minsan meron kaming guests, Elder, hindi magsasalita. Pag tinanong mo na, pag nasa show ka na, ang answer is yes or no.
Wow.
Would not even expound on anything. So parang hindi mo alam, what do I do with this? O kaya naman, meron namang hindi pa nga uupo dito, ay sasabihan ka na, I don't want you to be asking these questions to me kasi it's bawal. So you would, what do I do now with a guest like that? So anyways, going back to your next question, which I think I will answer, they've been signaling us.
Okay. This is just the first half of our episode. You have to wait when we get back after a few reminders from our studio.
I really found it an opportunity for me to be part of Dynamic Living, because you don't have to be anybody. You don't have to be this or that kind of body or that kind of face to be invited as a guest. And I really appreciate the fact that Dynamic Living gives an opportunity to the locals of Cagayan de Oro to share what they know and what they have. And for someone like me, I don't think I would ever have an opportunity to be part of any TV station for that matter. But I thank God for Dynamic Living because they gave me the opportunity to speak my mind and my heart for education.
Gidahan lagi ko ato ato ni katong imong katong segment nga katong sa imo lagi nga aksidente ka nga nakita ni mo nga nagpatuol ka sa Ginoo nagamit ni mong propesyon nga nagsaad ka nga ang sa imong pagkaabogado imong tutok itutukan ni mo paghatag ni mo public service sa imong mga sa duha sulod sa duha ka tuig kay nagsaad ko nga Lord luwasan lang gyud ko ani nga aksidente kay saad na ko sa imo nga pinakauna nako nga tuig sa pagkaabogado akong iula para bali sa katawhan kay imo kong luwas ani nga aksidente ug mao to nga kaigsoonan nga gituman pud nako unya ang Dynamic Living, katong episode, Doc, mo to'y mas nakapaila pa lugar. Kana ako ningon ang mga tao, kana attorney, mas naka-identify ko sa imo. Kay di abi man namo nga ang kanang mga attorney. Ila ko nung imahin sa mga abogado kay istrikto, dili ma, kailing, dili ba na basta-basta madulan. Iko nga, oh, dali naman ko, sayon man ko duulon, pero lisod pagitawang. Tungkol sa kabisi. Bito, mas nakapahatag ko paduol bali kanako labi na sa katawhan nga nahimo bali ang Dynamic Living mo ay instrumento nga nakita sa katawhan nga inani dai pod ang kinabuhi sa abogado o inani pod di ay ang kinabuhi o kinsa si Attorney James Judith. So,
for us in the province when he guested, as a matter of fact I was with him when he guested late last year. And the first thing he noticed was the very impressive studio and equipment that you had. And no wonder that you were able to capture first the basic need of journalism and broadcasting. And secondly, you have a very nice format and program. And it was very important for him because during that part of the year, he was about to start his program, the basic health care program of the province, which we call Mr. Care Health System. And we are very proud that when he guested, a lot of our constituents in the province of Misamis Oriental was able to notice and see the program because it is replayed so many times. And the program has really jump-started. As a matter of fact, over 500,000 of our constituents have already experienced what our program is. And due to partly with this, the Hope Channel has helped us propagate our program.
Really, my experience with Dynamic Living, it natungagan akong kahanas man siguro na siya. Or ang akong kabagan na akong to face realities to public. And kanang camera mo na pinakalisod kayo tubangon. And also, it strengthened me. Kay ingon nila karagi tong sitawar stage fright kagurog yung kubasan na sa stage. Karon na si Dr. Jen kurang kurog karon na kunya wala na. So basically, thank you for Dynamic Living and good luck for another 11 years and more to come. Thank you.
So when I was after the interview, I was so grateful kasi I even said thank you to the Lord because some people would say, Sean, thank you for guesting. Sabi ko, hindi. Thank you for having me here. Kasi totoo lang, it wasn't only for me to inspire other people, but I'm also doing it for myself. Because it's a reinforcement wherein I'm reminded of my past. Ano yan eh, parang practice what you preach. So if I keep on telling, don't do this, when it's my turn, then of course, I won't do it. So you gave, Dynamic Living gave me a chance to be reminded of my past, na I'm still powerless, and I still need a God.
But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk but not faint. So, sa kanang verse, mag-claim ko na ang Dynamic Living will go more years to come because like an eagle It will just run and not be weary. It will walk and not faint. Thank you so much. So in behalf sa atong mga congressman, pag-usap, ug sa atong mayor, daghang salamat.
Welcome back to our Dynamic Living. You have seen our guest having been briefly interviewed in the first half of the episode for today. We have here Pastor Nelson Paulo, our Communication Director, and presently the Executive Secretary of South Philippine Union Conference. We have Ayn Daang Aktub, who is still very active in the production of our Dynamic Living. We have Dr. Jean Lurizzi, Mary Jean Lurizzi, physician, and at the same time our host in our talk show Dynamic Living, and the representation of our technical staff in the person of Andrew Sinining. I'm very sorry for mispronouncing it. Andrew Sinining. Today, may I get back to Pastor Paulo. Please describe the circumstances of our humble television station by then. At the beginning, we have evolved a little bit into something much better than we had been. Can you give us a brief description of what we had been before? Because it's different now.
Yeah, exactly. It's a good question because it will bring my mind back to the struggling years. We didn't have a studio like this,
yes.
Elder Golfan.
Okay.
I remember that our studio was just on the other side, where the old cameras are being stationed. The control room could be just the production room. A very small space, but we made use of it. We were just so driven with the production and producing programs. That was the force that also motivated us to pray for a bigger production studio. Like what we enjoy now. That is one of the challenges. No, the mention of Andrew, that we really were in need of cameras. We could only afford of just above the Instamatic like that. And the Technicolor result of the editing because of the different brands. And our people, we're also limited. We had only Joacob, Bibing Sanes, some other people just came in after the show was already fully blooming, developed. So that's part of the limitation. The budget, of course, because the budget, the finances, our consideration also in the operation of the South Philippine Union Conference then, we did not have so much thinking on the production because we were also new, and it's good that in the long run, we saw the need, and we are very happy our treasurer, the Elder Levy Baliton, has seen the need. That's why he has increased the budget, which we can really afford to accommodate more people and produce more programs.
Okay. Ayn, program production is fruit of the mind. Included in what you have envisioned prior to putting things in paper are the personnel who will be involved in each episode, diba? Can you tell us how do you get into the people who should be seen right on TV? I mean, do you have the special connection that brings you to these people and brings them to our program? Can you describe that process to us?
First of all, after the discussion of the episode, the topic, you know, for the episode, I consult the directory.
Okay.
Then I consult the directory.
Telephone directory. Yeah.
Telephone directory, wow. Or the internet. After consulting the directory, then I talk to, sometimes I go back to Jade, and then sometimes I ask Doc Jean, you know, who would be siguro fit for the show, and then they tell me the departments, and then I go back to the directory again and then try to call the directors, and then the secretary
will answer, of course, and then sometimes the secretary will make me talk to the director, but sometimes my call will just be, will end with the secretary. So the invitation would have to pass through the secretary before it reaches the person concerned.
Wow. Dr. Jean, of course, all of us would understand that your circle of connection must be a little larger than ordinary citizens because as a doctor, you are visited by all kinds of people. Because when people get sick, you know, the rich, the poor, they go to a doctor. And you have that privilege being a physician. When you choose the personnel, of course, after you have a meeting with the staff, are you giving them such thing as briefing prior to the airing of the program? Or are you just going directly to the presentation, which oftentimes are presented live? Can you give us also some description on that part?
First, the planning for the programs actually takes a long period of time.
Oh, wow.
In other words, it doesn't just, you know, that next week our episode is this, we discuss it immediately. No, we meet several times, so we plan as far as 1 year. So we plot all the episodes at least for 6 months.
Mm.
And for the 6 months that we plot the episodes, should there be problems with the guests at the time, we have to have standby episodes to fill that gap. And we also have to discuss who would be fit for this particular episode. So when we discuss that during the team meeting, I already give them ideas, okay, this would be the concept for this episode. This would be the best persons we need to talk to. During the first 5 years of dynamic living, we never had problems inviting because although we had problems because people would not know what hope is all about, it was more of, I went through a crisis at the time on the fifth year, and it was so difficult getting already my colleagues to guest my show. And so what happened was we had to shift now. So there was now a paradigm shift in the way we would present the show. That was the time when we started going to government agencies. Wow. We invited bankers this time. Mm-hmm. We invited gymnasts, everybody, nutritionists. Mm-hmm. So we now gave a different twist to dynamic living in order for us to survive the crisis that went through with it. But then, as you said, by God's grace, we were able to get them again to guest our shows. And the beautiful thing there, Elder, is initially the guests would say, I'm embarrassed, I have no experience being a guest. Okay naman, nanginginig sila, natatakot sila, no? But at the end of the show, when we put them at ease already, usually pagka yung mga after 15 minutes of the initial discussion, nag-warm up na sila. At the end of the show, they would say, can you invite us again? We'd love to be on your show again. So parabang,
wow,
it's so we're happy because like now we have a directory of who to invite,
mm-hmm,
and we would not have difficulty getting them again.
Okay.
So yun yung ikinaganda niyan. And the guests are not given actually copies of the script,
okay,
ahead of time. So pag dinala nila ni Ayn yung letters nila, they would ask, ano yung pag-aaralan namin? And so sometimes they're emailed of the topic guide.
Wow.
But basically, we have before the actual show, around 15, 20 minutes before the show, we have briefing already. So I would remind them that the questions are very general. The questions, you can answer that very well at your own perspective. There is nothing to worry because you're the best person to answer,
wow,
that. So we are able to put them at ease.
Wow.
Now, one other thing there is, this dynamic living is actually apolitical.
Okay.
So we don't discuss politics. We invite politicians, but we don't discuss politics at
very
all.
Very good, very good.
We are also, you know, non-sectarian. We invite priests, we invite pastors, reverends from other denominations, but we don't discuss religion.
Mm-hmm.
So we have quite a large a number of people watching us who likes the format of the show because we are just, you know, we are just us, dynamic living, wanting to serve the community through awareness, giving them the correct information, making them aware of this is the right thing to do, this is how you do it, and how you are going to go about it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm looking at that, in that perspective, I'm looking at the mission of Jesus Christ himself. Christ was non-sectarian. Christ was apolitical. I mean, he was the real representation of what dynamic living. He was just out there to serve. That's what Hope Channel actually is intending to do. Although some people have misunderstood the motive of this Hope Channel, but dynamic living is one example of what our motive is in reaching out to the public for valuable information that will help them improve their life. Now let me turn to Andrew. Andrew, I understand that in the production, the technical part, which is, as I have mentioned a while ago, one of the most important. What would you prefer? I understand that there were times when you have to take the shooting for live programs. But if you are to choose and your suggestion is taken, what would you suggest to our producers and to our hosts? Would you prefer recording the programs that will be subjected to edition, or would you like them to just be there and you put the show live? Can you give us the difference in these two?
Recording, okay na siya. Kay kung nai sayop may edit nimo, kung na kay gusto insert niya mga videos, pictures, ma-edit nimo, then during sa broadcast, makita na to nimo siya tanan. Mm-hmm. Pero ang mga tao mungod kay ganahan yung live.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Ang atong audience ba? Bisag, usara na ka kamera diha. Basta kay nainay, gibutan nga live sa ibabaw sa oh, really? TV nga, sa right side nga part or sa left side ba na. Ganahan yung silang tanaw. Kay live man dayon, bisaya na siya. So, mutong, bisag nagkalisod mi, bisag una-una, story-story mi, basig ambisyoso ra kay ta. Mag-live-live dani nga. Unsa ko'y knowledge na to, ali, pero ah, sige, ito ling, testing, hangtod nga, kaya raman siguro, muna man siguro ni. So, hangtod nga, naanad, dayon, muabot na po ng struggle kung para sa atong from daan nga studio, hangtod na abot din hi. So, wirings na po, dayon lahi na po ng equipment. So, kaya wala lagi mi, kanang knowledge kayo yung ani. So, ato mi sa internet, unsaon man ni. So, may gani ka natay kauban din hinga mayo kay siya mo kuan sa internet wa sa pangitaon. So, nakatabang ra gihapon. So, muna karon live gyud gihapon.
Wow.
Balag magkalisod.
Dr. Jen, I understand that there were times when shows have not been filmed right in the studio. You were out there somewhere in the field. How does that feel to you? And how do you go about in, you know, the preparation of the area where you are going, the contact of the persons there? Can you give us an explanation of that part?
Yeah, actually, sometimes we go directly to the people na kung saan dapat ang aming filming, no? Mm-hmm. So, Dynamic Living would go there. Like, for example, yun, naalala mo yung Drew when we had that, yung para sa fiesta ng Cagayan de Oro, we were showing what Cagayan de Oro is all about. Mm-hmm. And so, we got from one beautiful spot of Cagayan to the next one. So it was a very challenging, ano, di ba, Drew? Mahirap siya eh because and we also went to Amay Pakpak. We had to film 4 episodes right there at the very heart of Marawi City.
Wow.
Yes, with our Muslim brothers there who were very accommodating, very intelligent, loving people. So, in other words, we were just, you know, trying to reach out, do something else aside from here in the studio. But mind you, Elder, live shows are wonderful.
I agree.
You have to have an adrenaline rush because anytime makukuha ng camera, makikita sa mga TV monitors na may mali kayo or anything. Mm-hmm. But it's wonderful.
Pastor Paulo, we know that in television programming, variety is a key word. Meaning, it cannot be one form only. It cannot be one kind only. Can you give us the variety that we have in our Hope Channel programming, aside from the Dynamic Living, which is one of our best?
We are blessed today that there are so many producers that have just propped up, and after they have been inspired by this Dynamic Living, we have programs for the youth.
Okay.
In this generation, is addressing that. Mm-hmm. So suicide like that, that's for the youth. Since this is, according to them, suicide people are from 11 to something like only in the teenage. we have program for the family that is being taken care of by the family programs of our director for women's, and some other programs for social issues. We have Pangutana Pastor that answers all questions, not only religious questions, under the leadership of Pastor Gulfan, which now also sometimes handled by other pastors. We have Let's Pray. We can entertain their prayer requests. All people, we offer them the privilege to pray with them on their particular concerns. We have programs for all kinds of people, that ranges from childhood to retirement probably. That's what we can offer right now from Hope Channel.
Hope Channel, just like any other television channel, is always a manifestation of what we call teamwork. Different people for different roles. When we talk about program production, which is one of the most challenging, can you give words to some of the potential youth out there, Ayn? Because there are some out there, potential youth, who perhaps have things in mind that will help them be motivated. Because in Hope Channel, most of our staff are volunteer staff. We are not a business station. We are a service station, television station, but we are largely run by volunteer staff, such as you guys. You have your own profession in your area, and yet you devote a certain time here. Can you give words of encouragement and challenge to some of our potential young professionals who may have the same talent that you have? So they will have the motivation to participate, because we want more variety in the future and more production of similar programs.
Okay, to all who are interested, people of all ages, I know that you have lots of things in mind that you want to express. This is a good time and a good opportunity for you to express what you have in mind. Because here in Dynamic Living, you are not only dictated which topics to produce, but everybody here is given the chance to express themselves, express their own ideas. So you need not have a background, an exemplary resume. You just have the heart. And then once you have the heart and the interest, you don't know that everything will just fall into places. Just come and visit Hope Channel, especially Dynamic Living, and we welcome all of you.
Oh, now that led me to Dr. Jean, in the connections that you have. You know, there are some people, we have seen faces of what we call dignitaries.
Yes.
Men with very responsible position in government, in agencies, in banks. In most cases, when these people are invited for, particularly in their public presentation, talks or whatever, they are receiving large amount. Sometimes it varies from what in group that invites them are. Do we do that in Hope Channel, or are we trying to get them the feeling of being contaminated with the volunteerism in their participation with our program, Dr. Jean?
Well, actually, in 11 years of Dynamic Living, our guests have ranged from the ordinary tao, okay, yung mga vendors dyan, policemen, mm-hmm, up to doctors who are very highly specialized already, mm-hmm, to government employees, government, we have directors also. We have also governors, congressmen, mayors, and people even from Manila who are very willing to guest Dynamic Living. And the only way we can thank them is actually a very sweet thank you. Yun lang ang kaya namin ibigay, and maybe prepare some meals for them. That's all. And we make it a point that when we invite them, we tell them straight so that we cannot give them monetary things or any financial, wow, but then You will be surprised, Elder, that there are so many people out there who are willing to give their services properly invited, knowing when and what to do, how to say it, so that, you know, people would just love to serve also. Lahat yata ng tao talaga naman inherently would like to help others too. Wow. And before that, yung sinabi ni Ayn na in-invite na yung mga kabataan, we also have an offshoot of Dynamic Living. Andrew, oh, diba? Nandun ka na. And that is our...
Dynamic Youth.
Yes. Oh, okay. So, yun yung naging baby ni Dynamic Living, si Dynamic Youth. Yes, nanganak siya. Oh. Nagkaroon siya ng Dynamic Youth. Oh. And masaya yun, Andrew, diba?
Bibo siya, dayon mas lisod.
Okay, really,
yeah. Okay, daghan mo good tao nga ma-involve. Like, a Dynamic Living, kitara mo nang nadin, hey, kung ang Dynamic
Youth... Smaller group.
Naanay audience. So daghan na kayo mong atimanon, daghan na mic gamiton.
Pagsugod nato Drew dinhi, di ba? Lisod ka ayo gyapon.
Yeah, some people are doing that in much bigger studios where there will be a large place for audiences who can participate in the discussion. Andrew, let me go back to your side. The technical aspect. Many of you there are volunteer young people, but some of you are professional. I mean, you have the degrees, IT, etc., but you are content in doing a volunteer work. What do you have in mind? Is this a kind of a dedication or simply a commitment? Or do you have some other projections? What can you achieve when you come as volunteer and you are on the technical production? Can you share an idea? Kay murag representative mong sa grupo nga daghan mo.
Yeah, sakto na siya, Pastor. Daghan kayo yung media nagkalain lahi nga kurso. Dayon, wala yun nakainsakto kurso.
Oh, really?
Wala yun nakainsakto. So, tingali, ako ang pinakalayo.
Oh.
Kaya nga akong kurso is horticultural management.
Oh, really?
So, tanom na siya. Branch agriculture. So, nauna na ako, murag ako ang pinakalayo sa tanang profession nga nadire. Pero, pag-abot mong kunda mo, gi-workshop mi na ay dili po ingon ang kauban ra po nato din ni sila ni Johnster sa una. So gi-workshop mi nila si lang Kuya Bibing kung unsa imong buhaton. So wala yu ko kabalo kung ganahan ba ko ani kay even computers dili ko kabalo mo gamit. Pero pagkaabot na ko din hin, nagunahon ako basig mo ni panahon nga magamit ko sa buhat sa Ginoo. Kay dili man pud ko kabalo kaayo mo kanta, makakanta lang pero di kayo. Di pud kayo ko kabalo mo wali. Dili pud ko kaayo kanang anang Bible study kay kung type murag dili kayo ko yung anak ka kuan sa mga tao ba.
No. Oh.
So naguna-una ko nga basic diri ko magamit sumutong naguna-una ko nga nag-practice ko hangtod nga nakabalo ko dayon. Sa una mo ko ng Hope Channel, dili pa kayo sa inga na kakuandok ba?
Yes.
Mag-ingon ka sa mga tao, wala sila kaila. Pero sa panahon nga na ang nanay mag-ingon sa imo, uy, nakakita ako ana, murabi ito, nindot kayang feeling nga, napadalanginan po sila. So muto nga, nagpadayon, hangtod nga, diri po ko nakabalo, like, dinhi ko nakalungog ang mga nindot nga mga message, dinhi na sa Hope Channel, dayon, sa Dynamic Living, mga person nga mga dili kay nimo makita tungod sa kailang ka katalagsaon o kanang kabisi sa kinabuhi pero dinhi nakita nato sila nakahimuta sa nga nakahatag og oportunidad nga makapapicture ka uban sa ila.
Okay.
So something ana dayon siguro ang pinakakuan jud sa ako ang ano nagpabilin ko hangtod karon tuod kay nagtuog ko nga mo gyud di ang ministry nga para sa ako siguro nga mapuslan pud ko sa sa Ginoo ba.
Yeah. Spiritual gifts as we have mentioned a while ago, God knows who to use for whatever part of his work because God is the number one person in the universe who is service orientation man gyud nang sa Ginoo. Pastor Paulo, any projection for the future regarding?
We have not really mentioned one of the most challenging part of the history that involves our Dr. Jean here.
Okay.
And that one, that the international recording that was held in Manila.
Wow, yeah, hope.
That was in 2007. She, of course, she was gifted with young legs young heart and young mind then. That was almost 8 years ago.
Yeah, 2007.
8 years, 7 years ago. I remember her come to SSD. Imagine flying from here with her work here occupied. She is already occupied. She's tired, but she has to fly to SSD, not only in Manila, but from Manila, she will drive. She will be taken.
To drive to Silang.
To Silang. And I remember one time, of course, that was only one time, that after the recording, she lost all her strength.
Wow.
Yeah. She could hardly walk because she had to. That was done. She commuted Cagayan de Oro and Manila because that was the schedule. She had to come back because of her work. Remember, can you tell me one of those times that you could really hardly walk and she was really dead tired that time? And that was the program that she produced that blessed not only Philippines, but the whole world. And you were part
of that.
You were part of that when you also recorded your My God is Real.
Okay.
Dr. Jean, you had that experience, I know.
Yeah, because we had to produce 13 episodes only very short time. So actually 2 days only. I had to produce six episodes and 7 episodes in 1 day. Mm-hmm. So can you just imagine having to compact everything there in your mind? You have to study and you have to interview your guests. So at the end of it all, he was right. I couldn't walk. I cried out of my frustration because I think na mamatay na siguro sa kakakoy. Yeah, that was one time na I said, this is it. I'm not going to go any further.
I think the most satisfying part of being a television person is viewer response. Mm-hmm. Kay matawag mo guna tug naa na ang imong naong na-expose na ka sa public, you are not a private person anymore. You have become, in a way, a person who belongs to the community by nature of the service you do in the television. Can you share with us some of these experiences that brings joy to you, that even when you are alone by yourself, just by the responses of the people who have come to you expressing, can you tell us some of these experiences? Because that's the real reward of people like you who are involved in program production.
Well, actually, when you walk downtown and you meet even a buko vendor, or the most recent one ay yung akong suki sa kamote, you know, who comes from the Bukids, they come down and bring their wares there, and then they just make latag that one at the roadside. Mm-hmm. And then one morning at around 5:30, I was there trying to pili this mga kamote. I want, you know, I love these violet kamotes. Yeah. And medyo duol to siya sa ako. Ingon siya nga, ma'am, naagyod ka na, kitangyod ka na ako, ma'am. Ingon ko sa iya nga, asa man. Ingon siya nga, ma'am, ka nang, ikaw ba yun ang nasa hope? And so I smiled and I said na, yeah, I think so. And then she was telling me, ma'am, naglalis gid mi sa akong husband. Kaya ako gyud siyang ginan, suki na ako na ka nang naa sa television. So I had to bring my husband para mailhan ka.
Kusog ka mo ang to?
Dili gid ko gahangyo sa ilaha, kaya nga maluoy naman ka sa ila. But the best thing there is actually, it teaches you humility.
Amen.
Because, you know, knowing na you are right there at the forefront, so you cannot be, kung mataray ka dati, which was I was actually, and I still am, pero medyo na-tone down ng gamay yon. So it makes you realize na being part of the program, you have to live a life accordingly.
Amen.
Wow, thank you very much. I also share that kind of feeling when some people somewhere come and approach you and tell you, are you the guy on TV? And then expressing their appreciation for what you have done. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have just heard the dynamic living, particularly the personnel who are involved in the production. We will continue because this is an ongoing public service of Hope Channel. We thank so much our communication director, who is also now having an additional but heavy responsibility as executive secretary, the second highest ranking officer of the South Philippine Union of Seventh-day Adventists, in the person of Pastor Nelson Paulo. We have Ayn, who is going on with her service as a teacher in Millennium Academy and at the same time doing some other jobs as a young professional, and at the same time being a mother to her children, and a good wife to her husband.
Yes.
Dr. Jean here, who will continue in her service as a doctor, a public figure, and following in the footsteps of the Master Healer, the Lord Jesus Christ Himself, and the representative of our unsung heroes in every television production, our technical staff. We are expressing our appreciation also for the to the viewing public. If you have responses, please send your text messages or email to the telephone numbers you can see on the screen and at the same time to the website of Hope Channel. We hope to see you again. Remember, Dynamic Living will be there in your TV twice a week. Dr. Jean and the other personnel who are invited. See you again. God bless everyone.